everyone. My name is Annie Rubin. I am a registered dietitian nutritionist, and I work with adults struggling with a host of underlying symptoms from autoimmune and inflammatory conditions that include pain, fatigue, digestive challenges, and just an overall reduced quality of life. So in my work with my clients, I help them implement a personalized nutrition roadmap really designed to improve mobility, concentration, and energy levels to ultimately have them live the vibrant and fulfilling life that they were meant to have. So the concept of intuitive eating has become quite popular lately. Many people are turning their backs on dieting, and for a good reason, because diets don't work if you are trying to lose weight and get healthy. So today's discussion is focused on the philosophy behind intuitive eating. So before I jump in, I just need to attach a disclaimer to this video that the information in today's talk is not a substitute for the diagnosis, treatment, or care of disease by a medical provider. This is for informational purposes only. So please contact your qualified health professional for any changes to your medical care. So what is intuitive eating? Intuitive eating was developed by two registered dietitians, Evelyn Tribble and Elise Reich. Through their own nutrition practices, they found that diets were not working, and there must be a better way to help people improve their health and their relationship with food without having to follow a specific meal plan or calorie count. So intuitive eating was born, and it follows 10 principles to really help clients become intuitive eaters. And these principles are based on the three core characteristics of intuitive eating. One, eat for physical reasons, not emotional reasons. Two, rely on your own hunger and satiety cues. And three, give yourself unconditional permission to eat. That includes what, when, and how much. So how do you become an intuitive eater? So tuning into your body and actually listening to what it needs takes time. In fact, intuitive eating follows 10 principles, and each principle must be fully mastered to help you become an intuitive eater. So these principles include rejecting the diet mentality, so realizing that diets don't work, and trying to like throw away the fact that calorie restriction or restricting certain food groups just to lose weight is not the way to go. The second one is honoring your hunger, so really paying attention to when you're hungry, and if you are hungry, eat. Don't follow food rules that say you have to wait a certain number of hours before eating, or eat at certain times. It really allows you to honor what your body needs at that given point in time. The third principle is making peace with food. So this helps you put foods into kind of everything fits category versus something is good versus something is bad. It really takes away the food labels. Challenging the food police. So, telling that voice in your head, you can't eat chocolate. Telling them that it's okay for you to eat chocolate. So really kind of challenging those notions that certain foods are good and bad for you. The fifth one is feeling your fullness. So again, recognizing when you are full. And to be honest, this is a very difficult one for people to do because they don't really know, to that point that they are comfortably full or, didn't eat enough or ate too much. So that is something that takes a lot of practice. The sixth one is discovering your satisfaction factor. So, realizing that eating and food really brings you a sense of enjoyment and, find foods and eating experiences that are satisfying, and that goes really to the importance of allowing yourself to eat whatever you want. The seventh one is coping with your emotions without using food. This one is a huge struggle for many, many, many people. I know for me especially, I tend to be a stress eater, or if I'm bored and I just want something in my mouth, I actually have to take a step back and realize like, wait, I'm not hungry. I don't need food right now. So this is a really big hurdle for many people to jump over. Respecting your body. So realizing that there is no one perfect body type. We are all different. We all have different genetics. So you have to do what is best for you and kind of break through those stereotypes of what you think you should look like, because not everyone looks like a photoshopped model in a magazine. The ninth one is exercise. So really feeling how movement affects your body and how it makes you feel, hopefully makes you feel good. And then the last one is honoring your health with gentle nutrition. So remembering that, yes, nutrition is important. And I love that this is the last step, because once you kind of get through all the different steps of allowing yourself to eat everything, giving yourself unconditional permission to have candy and cookies and chocolate, you start to realize that those foods are great every once in a while, but they don't make you feel good all the time. And so once you kind of move through the paces of intuitive eating, you start to recognize like, oh, I do feel better when I have, you know, more fruits and vegetables in my diet. And so that's really a way to honor your health with, you know, gentle, and they call it gentle nutrition because it doesn't have to be perfect all the time, but, you know, you're doing things that make you feel good. So is intuitive eating just another weight loss gimmick? No. Intuitive eating we call it a weight neutral approach. So it is not for someone looking to lose weight as their main goal. However, weight loss can be a great and, you know, wonderful side effect of following intuitive eating. Intuitive eating helps people become more self-aware. It allows them to tune into their own hunger and satiety cues to really guide their eating patterns and choices. So intuitive eating also removes any restrictions or food rules, really to help clients stop the vicious, restrict, binge cycle of eating and be more accepting of their food choices. So we are all born to be intuitive eaters. If you look at infants and children, they eat when they're hungry and they stop when they're full. And sometimes they eat only bread and sometimes they will choose vegetables, but overall their eating patterns are pretty stable and well-balanced. So societal pressures and dieting have really caused us to ignore our own internal cues. And over time, we learn to distrust ourselves with food and our food choices. So intuitive eating helps bring that trust back. So I like to think of intuitive eating as a self-discovery process. It's really a journey with lots of twists and turns to help people get back in touch with themselves and to really find the things that satisfy them and that helps them feel good. So it is not a quick fix and it's not for everyone, but you know, I feel like many of the principles can be used on an individual basis to really help my clients improve their relationship with food. I will also note that using intuitive eating when you're managing an autoimmune disease can come in handy, and I'll be discussing this more in an upcoming video. So just to recap, I covered the basics of intuitive eating and, you know, the principles of it and the philosophy behind it and, you know, how you can start becoming an intuitive eater. So if you enjoy the video, please hit the subscribe button at the bottom. I put out these videos every week or so. Just, you know, another nutrition tip. And I also talk about different, you know, connections between food and inflammation and autoimmune diseases and lifestyle too. So hit subscribe. Thanks for watching and I will see you next time.